What is the first thing that comes to your mind when you think about SpaceX? Self-landing rockets, commercial space flights, or maybe innovations in space technology? Of course, these are all good associations, but don't forget, what is the main goal of the company? When Elon Musk founded the company in 2002, as the main goal, he set the colonization of Mars and making humanity an interplanetary species. After Elon realized what the space industry looks like and how expensive space flights are, he decided that before they start thinking of space exploration, SpaceX must significantly reduce the cost of space transport. Now, 19 years after SpaceX was founded, the company has managed to create reusable rockets and successfully reduce the price of a kilogram launched into Earth orbit. For comparison, the cost per launch of 1 kilogram into space by the space shuttle was around $41,000, while the cost per launch of the same kilogram on board SpaceX rocket, the Falcon 9, is just $2,700. If everything goes as planned, the price of a kilogram of launching into space on board Starship, the new SpaceX rocket will reach even $10. Thanks to such a low price, Elon Musk's big dreams of colonizing Mars finally becomes real. In December 2020, during an interview, he even said that he's highly confident SpaceX will launch people towards Mars in 2026. This would mean that in a few years, we will see the first human on the surface of the red planet. When we talk about the landing of humans on Mars, the key question arises, how exactly will they get there? Let's start with the fact that before the first crewed mission to Mars starts, we need to transport a lot of cargo to Mars. For this purpose, SpaceX will send at least 2 cargo ships to Mars. The goal of the cargo mission will be to place power mining and life support infrastructure for future flights. It is also planned to confirm water resources and identify hazards during this mission. If all of the mission's assumptions will be successfully completed, the first crewed mission to Mars will be launched after exactly 2 years. Astronauts will have to wait these 2 years due to the movement of the planets. Only once every 2 years the Earth and Mars align themselves in a suitable configuration that allows space travel. Thanks to this, the best possible alignment of the planets, the journey from Earth to Mars will take only about 7 months, which is not such a long time when we talk about space travels. As a spaceship for a manned mission, SpaceX will of course use their latest Starship rocket. The Starship is 120 meters in height and is made of 2 parts. The spacecraft is stocked on a rocket booster called Super Heavy and Starship payload fairing at 9 meters in diameter and 18 meters high, resulting in the largest usable payload volume of any current launchers. More precisely, the payload volume of this giant rocket is up to 1,100 cubic meters, which means it can carry up to 100 people. At the moment, we do not know how exactly the interior of the spaceship will be arranged, but it is certain that SpaceX will need to include in its design some of the necessary accommodation needed to provide a crew with adequate living conditions. Each astronaut will have his own special sleeping cabin, which will resemble the ones we know from Japanese capsule hotels. These sleeping cabins may not be too big, but remember that the cabins will only be used during sleep. Most of the time, the crew will spend in other rooms such as the passenger area. A space flight, as long as this one to Mars, will also require the crew members to change their daily routine. For example, due to exposure to zero gravity conditions for long periods of time, astronauts may experience problems with their bones, muscles, and cardiovascular system. In order to prevent these problems, astronauts will have to exercise regularly, and therefore a special room and machines for this purpose must be included in the interior design of the Starship. The zero-gravity conditions also require the interior design to include a special toilet, similar to the one present at the International Space Station. Inside the Starship, there will also be a special kitchen space, of course. The food served on the board Starship will be quite different from this typical dinner on the Earth. Meals will consist of thermostabilized food, like cans of tuna, that have been heat processed to destroy deleterious microorganisms and enzymes. Another room that, of course, will have to be on the Starship board is a hold space, with all cargo that will be needed during the mission indirectly to Mars, such as Mars rover vehicles. When we already know what the interior of the spaceship that will take people to Mars will look like, let's move on to what the whole journey will look like. The first stage of the Starship system, named Super Heavy Booster, will bring Starship spacecraft into the Earth's orbit. For this purpose, the booster will use 37 Raptor engine, powered by sub-cooled liquid methane and liquid oxygen propellants. After lifting into orbit, the booster and the spacecraft will separate and the Super Heavy booster will return to land at the launch site. The Super Heavy booster is fully reusable, so it can be used again in the next mission. Once the Starship spacecraft with the crew on board will be already in space, it is likely that the rocket will be refueled by a second Starship specially designed for this purpose. After that, Starship spacecraft will be able to begin its long journey towards Mars, which, as I mentioned, will take about 7 months. Well, the journey itself shouldn't be too problematic. Landing on Mars could be a more difficult thing. The rocket will need to decelerate and perform a specific maneuver in order to land. The matter is even more difficult when we consider these two facts. First, Starship will be entering Mars' atmosphere at a speed of 27,000 km per hour, which is 9 times faster than a pistol bullet. Secondly, the rocket will have to withstand the enormous heat that will be generated during entering the Martian atmosphere at such a high speed. Due to a heat problem, SpaceX has used stainless steel, and the Starship design will be able to withstand temperatures as high as 815 degrees Celsius. The entire process of landing on Mars will be very difficult, and definitely, it will be a critical moment for the entire mission. Even if everything goes great and SpaceX successfully lands the first human mission on Mars' surface, we must still remember that the first colonizers must have a way to go back to Earth. Starship is fully reusable, but there is a problem with refueling rockets on Mars. To solve this problem, SpaceX engineers plan to use a chemistry trick called the Sabatier process. The Sabatier process uses a nickel catalyst to synthesize methane from atmospheric carbon dioxide and hydrogen, which can be extruded from local Martian water ice. Having liquid methane and liquid oxygen leads to the possibility of producing rocket fuel. This is what the first mission of Mars looks like. If you are interested in more content related to space exploration, I invite you to subscribe to my channel, Innovative Perspective, and check out other videos.